Welcome back to the today's class on advanced switchgear. Today we will be seeing about short circuit testing. There are three types of testing stations available for short circuit testing. First one is field type testing station, laboratory type testing station, and composite testing station. Field type testing station. Field type of testing. The power required for testing is directly drawn from a large power system. So, while testing a circuit breaker, the power to test the circuit breaker is drawn from an actual power system. The breaker being tested is connected in the power system. So, when a circuit breaker is tested, this circuit breaker is connected to a real power system. And the test is carried out in a real situation. This type of testing provides most convenient method of testing high voltage circuit breakers. Since power system has a very higher voltage rating, so the circuit breaker which is connected in this power system should have a high voltage rating. And circuit breakers which are manufactured for high voltage ratings should be tested by field type testing stations. Field type testing stations suffer from the drawback of limited available flexibility of the power system. So, the field type testing station is connected with the power system and this power system is operating in real time with consumers. So, the limitations are present and the flexibility of testing is also minimized. And this is the drawback of field type testing station. It is difficult to set system for specified rate of rise of restriking voltage for high voltage breakers. While using a field type testing station with the power system connected, so, to set the rate of rise of restriking voltage for a high voltage breaker, it is very difficult in field type testing station. Laboratory type testing station. In laboratory type testing station, special generators called short circuit generator provide power for testing. So, a separate generator set is available for testing the circuit breaker in a laboratory. In this type of testing station, it is possible to vary test condition at will. So, the developers and researchers can test the circuit breaker according to the will or according to the design parameters of the circuit breaker in a laboratory type testing station. Establishment of short circuit testing plant, particularly of laboratory type, is exceedingly a costly project. So, to test a circuit breaker, we are using a laboratory and this laboratory includes a generator and a driver set. So, this generator and the driver set will be a costly project and it will be a very tedious work so that the complete power system should be modeled and the generating station is to be constructed inside a laboratory. So, it becomes the cost of the project very high. It is not possible for all switchgear manufacturers to have such a facility for their own. So, a switchgear manufacturer cannot have a facility in a laboratory type testing station. So, these type of testing stations will be available as a separate and all manufacturers of switchgear will give their manufactured circuit breaker to the testing station and get tested and certified. Composite testing station. A composite testing station is a combination of field type testing station and a laboratory type testing station. So, in a composite testing station, both the field type as well as laboratory type testing stations are present. Description of a simple testing station. In a simple testing station, short circuit power is supplied by specially built short circuit generator. So, in a testing station, the short circuit power required to operate the circuit breaker is provided by a short circuit generator. This is the model of a composite testing station, and in the testing station has two or more generators as shown in the figure. Here you can see the drive and the generator which is coupled mechanically, and the neutral of the generator is grounded through a resistance. And here you can see the short circuit generator with the impulse exciter. The supply voltage which is provided by the short circuit generator and the impulse exciter is fed to the master circuit breaker, and after the master circuit breaker, resistors, reactors and the make switches are present. Resistors and reactors are helpful to or decrease or increase the short circuit current provided by the generator. After this, a make switch is there, and then the make switch is divided into three segments of links, and these three segments of links are connected to a separate short circuit transformers. After the short circuit transformers, there are four test cells. We will see these test cells in the upcoming slides. Composite testing station, three-phase induction generator and a special type of impulse excitation is provided. So, the different type of impulse excitation and a three-phase induction generator is used in composite testing station. Series resistors and reactors are provided for the adjustment of magnitude of short circuit current and power factor. So, in the testing station, the generator power is fed through the series resistor and reactor, and these two components are used to adjust the magnitude of short circuit current and also helpful to adjust the power factor of the current which is provided to the circuit breaker. The master circuit breaker has capacity higher than that of circuit breaker being tested. In case of circuit breaker being tested fails, the master circuit breaker protects the circuit and breaker under test. So, the short circuit generator will provide the power to the testing circuit breaker through a master circuit breaker. So, if the testing circuit breaker fails to operate, then the master circuit breaker will operate and protects the circuit as well as the testing circuit breaker. Making switch is a specially designed circuit closing device which can close at the desired moment and can withstand the making current. So, a making switch is designed so that this making switch can close the circuit at the desired time, and this making switch has a capacity to withstand the making current of the circuit breaker. To give the test voltage other than generator voltage, transformers are provided. To give a voltage greater than or lesser than the generator voltage, the short circuit transformers are provided in the composite testing station. In addition to above equipment for measurement, record and controls are present. So, these equipments such as generator, reactor, resistor, transformers, making switch are used to conduct the test, whereas to measure a record and control, there are several equipments which are present in the composite testing stations. Sequence switch provides a sequential operation of composite testing station. So, this sequential switch has a very high making capacity. Auxiliaries. Testing stations are very compact design with short circuit connection for short circuit test so that the generator output may be utilized to the full extent. So, the auxiliaries which are connected to the short circuit testing station are very compact in design, and it can withstand a very short circuit current during the short circuit test, and this short circuit test and the generator and the circuit breaker are connected in a short position so that the generator output is completely utilized to its fullest extent. Breaker to be tested is enclosed in a test cell made of reinforced concrete having a problem of observation while test is in progress. So the test cell is made up of reinforced concrete, and this concrete will have a provision to observe the test in progress. Direct loading equipment is located in control room, which is remote from test cell but situated so as to allow test breaker to be observed. So the loading of the equipment can be seen from the control room, but the control room is located far away from the test cell so that any dangerous situation that occurs in the test cell will not affect the operating personnel in the control room, but a visible view is given to the operator from the control room to the test cell to observe the breaker. The control operations are carried out from the control room. So all the auxiliaries and the control equipments and the recording equipments, the measurement equipments are present in the control room will be helpful to perform the test in the circuit breaker and helps us to provide the correct characteristics of the circuit breaker under test. Thank you.